you, darling. Gumi, may I ask you? Yes, please.
Good afternoon, everyone. This is actually the first time that I'm going to face such a large audience. I might be a little nervous, but just like bear with me. I'm only a film old, so clearly all my experience only comes from that one film, even though I did work behind the camera for a few years. But because the topic is the way our cinema is changing, as Tahir also said earlier, that it definitely is a ripple effect. We've had great films. We had a golden era in our industry where we had Satyajit Ray, we had Guru Dutt, we had films like Mother India, Sahib Bibi or Ghulam. And they were extremely progressive films and they made a mark everywhere. And I feel we are not changing, but we are sort of back to what Indian cinema was known for. We always made films that sort of spoke about our society, because earlier I feel this was the largest medium we had to let the world know what our society is all about, what our minds are like, what our intellect is like. And it is really exciting to know that, you know, I got a chance to enter the films at a point where that time is back again. I feel a very big reason why this could happen was first our audiences. A film is made for people to watch. I believe a complete film is something that entertains you. It doesn't necessarily have to be preachy. It doesn't have to have a social message. And when there are films that sort of find a balance, because that's what our movies were all about earlier. It wasn't ki acha agar main pakiza bana raha hu to usme koi bahut impactful social message hona chahiye. Nahi. जब अलग अलग टीम्स और अलग अलग डिपार्टमेंट साथ में मिलके काम करते हैं और एक ब्यूटीफुल प्रोडक्ट बनता है जो बहुत ही ऑनेस्ट हो, जो आज आप बनाना चाहते हो टुवर्ड्स इट, सो आई थिंक इट्स अ सक्सेसफुल फिल्म. बट यस, ऑडियंसेस हैव रियली चेंज्ड. टुडे अ 15 ईयर ओल्ड बॉय इन ऋषिकेश एंड प्रोबेबली माय सिस्टर एंड आई वॉच द सेम फॉरेन शोज एंड द सेम फॉरेन टेलीविजन, विच आई मे बी रॉन्ग बट आई बिलीव वॉज इन द केस अर्लियर. सो क्लियरली एक्सपोजर इज अ लॉट टुडे. When we have shows like Fargo and we have amazing, we have in fact great shows that are also being made in India today. And definitely the exposure has increased a lot, which automatically gives us a lot of space to experiment with ourselves. But again, I am going to speak of my film because that is the only experience I've had. Being somebody who's not been from the film industry, I'm not a star child. But again, as Tahir said, that doesn't matter anymore today. All that matters is the work you do. And if your work is good, you will be appreciated. And I think it's also really amazing when you see big production houses and big studios and corporates picking up subjects that they wouldn't have picked up traditionally earlier. As an actor, all you want to do is experiment and push yourself and see what new can you do? And today when we have a chance to do that, it really, really, really pleases me a lot. And again, our writers and our directors, like, you know, for a film like Dam Laga Ke Haisha, which has been written by Sharad Kataria, for him, I feel more than anybody else, because this question has been asked, people have asked me this very often, like, you know, you've broken a stereotype, what were you thinking? I believe it wasn't I who broke a stereotype, it was the writer and the director and the producer who thought that, okay, we could make a film like Dam Laga Ke Haisha and it will do well. And that's the reason I got a chance, and I believe, I feel, even for everybody else over here, none of us have gotten in doing a conventional part. Be it Vicky Donor, be it Mardani, or even Ishak Zadeh, I don't think any of us fit what your, I'm sorry I'm speaking for you guys, but I don't think any of us fit what a conventional actor or actress today should be like. But what is exciting is that everything is content driven today. People want to see exciting things, people want to see new cinema. And I just hope that we continue to make interesting films, because Tahir has pretty much covered everything. So I would just like to keep it small and sweet. I hope this wave turns into a tsunami really soon and drowns all of us. Have a good evening for now.
Thank you, Gumi. And now I'd like Arjun to speak. Yes, Arjun. Commercial, mainstream kind of cinema. And someone who's clearly done more than just that with films like Ishak Zadeh, Finding Fanny.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I have a tremendous sense of deja vu being in front of a mic on a stage and have Rajiv Masand. yes, I'm sorry if I'm a bit nervous because this is the first time I've stepped out after that to talk in a public forum. More importantly, I think all my fellow contemporary actors have covered pretty much everything I also would have underlined or spoken of. पर मैं संक्षेप में कहूँगा, जैसे आयुष्मान हिंदी में वार्तालाप कर रहे थे, मैं संक्षेप में कहूँगा, I concur with all three of them to the extent where I believe it's not about new age cinema, like Bhumi was saying. We've made all kinds of cinema for so many years. Like Ayushman mentioned, there was a divide and there was a conversation that happened about niche, about ye art cinema hai, ye is type ki film hai, ye us type ki film hai. I think there has been an evolution in our audience, primarily. That's why we have been allowed to be successful as actors. I think we are all four prime examples of breaking the norm and not being conventional. And I'll talk about my work because we all have been flaunting our own work only for the last few minutes. It primarily comes down to, I've grown up here in the fraternity. I've also done exactly the same stuff that Tahir was talking about. Danced on other people's songs to learn dancing, done action class, done monologues from old Hindi films, Aaj Mere Paas Bangla Hai, Balance Hai, Gaadi Hai, Vagera. We've done all that. And then when I was offered Ishak Zade, when I auditioned and I got the script, I'm sure pretty much everybody here knows the interval is something unbelievable in terms of Hindi film writing. And I won't even go very far back. I would say 2001 was when Hrithik Roshan made his conventional Hindi film debut, which was very, very successful because I think our audience was still very, very aspirational then. They had no sense of, they had still not evolved in terms of exposure, experience, Western civilization, having the internet, television, for example, or just generally the conversations were very different then. We were still very, very aspirational in our film viewing. That's why we had so many more stars and superstars. When I was offered Ishak Zade, when I read that scene, I just got back to thinking maybe even 3 or 4 years before that film released, to be told that a Hindi film hero for a banner like Yash Raj Films would make his debut in a film where he ends up molesting a girl after marrying her and is going to be called the main lead of a film and I would be accepted by the entire country. Is just a prime example of the change in the thought process of an audience. They are much, much more evolved than we give them credit for. Vikas is not here today. I think Vikas would have been a prime example to talk about a film like Queen wouldn't have even been able to get made maybe a couple of years back. And that all stems from the fact that now we have an audience that is willing to spend money to not just go ki yaar time pass karke aate theater mein. Time pass karne ke liye hamare paas aaj 3G hai phone pe. Hamare paas aaj TV mein 100 channels hai. We can download things whenever we want. And time pass karne ke liye aur AC khane ke liye ab logon ne theater mein jana band kar diya. The time for average is going away. Filmmaking is a serious business because like everybody was saying, there is a huge dichotomy in our audience. The same person will not appreciate Finding Fairy the same way maybe somebody in Bombay might. In Bihar, it won't even see a release. But that does not stop an actor or a director or producer from taking chances. We still continue to do that. Primarily it stems from the fact that we have grown up in that environment and the change of the thought. We are an extension of the audience. Our acceptance is because they find a relation to us, they correlate to us. There is no sense of, arre mujhe Arjun jaise banna. There is an idea, arre Arjun apne jaisa hai. So when the audience finds a believability and a relatability to you, then they don't mind coming and seeing you pushing the envelope. Because Arjun apne jaisa to apne sab bhi ho sakta. It becomes as simple as that. So if there is a boy who meets me in Jodhpur when I went for a wedding after Ishak Zade released and he said, arre jaise aap ladki se baat karte ho na Ishak Zade main bhi waise hi karta hu. And I'm like, okay, I lived in Bombay all my life, but I didn't even know. They correlate and they feel so much of emotion towards the characters that they watch. So audiences still want to come to theaters, they still want to enjoy themselves, but they don't want to be taken for granted. And that's why I feel the new age argument, conversation, of course we will have commercial films, but eventually we as actors, the onus lies upon us to take those risks. I mean, I'm very proud of Anushka Sharma for doing NH10. A few years back, people would have disowned the film. I mean, they would have said, yeah, why do you want to show this aspect of India? We should hide it from the world. We should not speak about it. Today, people are applauding them for making a film that is real. It is very, very real. I mean, it is gut-wrenchingly real. A guy like me who's used to seeing all kinds of cinema shut my eye when she is in that car in the end because it is very real. Mardani, for example, who would have thought that you talk about child trafficking in a country which is such a taboo subject, it exists. These thoughts, these ideas have always existed in society. We have been very scared to translate them on screen. what's happened is, with our audience being accepting, them having exposure, them wanting to start interesting conversations, it's allowed us to make all kinds of cinema. Some will fail, some will work. But the idea is we will keep pushing the envelope, and eventually, I hope, and I'm a big believer of commercial cinema. I mean, I've grown up watching all kinds of commercial cinema. Ram Lakhan, Mr. India, you can name it. I always loved commercial cinema, and my choices reflect that. But I hope that our industry finds the correct balance. It's something that has been lacking for many, many years. Is we just ride a wave of what we think is working. If a horror film works, you will announce 20 other horror films. If a romantic comedy based in London is working, 30 units will land up in London to shoot, because wahan pe rebate bhi milta. That philosophy and ideology has to change from the industry, because the audience does not care about all that. The audience wants to have a good time, but they want layers now. They don't want, like I said, time pass and average is something that is available at fingertips to people. We have to go beyond, and we have to think beyond. And I think this conversation is just the starter. At the end of the day, I think the full credit goes to the people who come to theatres, and they reject bullshit that we give them. I think that is very, very important. And I know critics get a lot of flack, but there are certain films that wouldn't have seen the light of the day if it wasn't for people who give you that opinion. Go watch Ship of Thieves, go watch Lunchbox. I mean, who many years back would have thought that we'd have a Lunchbox happening in our country? Who would have thought Dam Laga Ke Haisha? And I'm going to use this as a commercial example, primarily, because the main lead of that film, it's a hero-driven so-called industry, which I completely negate, because I think it's content-driven more than it's ever been, because even our biggest superstars are gullible when they don't make decent cinema, even commercially. He had a film that didn't do well. It wasn't successful at the box office a month before Dam Laga Ke Haisha released. And Dam Laga Ke Haisha's trailer intrigued everybody, but everybody was saying, yeah, will it, won't it, will it, won't. And I'm talking about the industry, I'm not talking about the audience. Because the audience is clearly given an outstanding verdict. We within the industry were thinking, yeah, kya hoga, kya hoga, kya hoga, kya nahi hoga. Log dekhenge, what kind of a film will it be? And on, I think the reviews come out by Friday afternoon. I think by Friday afternoon, the critics had spoken, the audience has heard the critics' call. They started going to the theatre. The film started with 1 crore rupees on the first day. It has done over 28 crore rupees. I think to do a Dam Laga Ke Haisha or a Band Baja Barat has no value than doing 200 crore films, if the kind of love and appreciation. And I'm sure he'll also do 100 crore film, I'm sure she'll also do 100 crore film, but that 100 crore has no value unless you get the kind of love Dam Laga Ke Haisha has got. So I think the audience love is what we need to work towards more than just numbers, because numbers come and go, but that love is what will take us forward and make us take more chances. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, Anand. You know, we'll get into the discussion here. What a great time to have this conversation. Literally, you know, in the period when we